having God to do, to make their own choices. So they have a freedom to make choices, and they can do a lot with their freedom. They can help others, they can be loving to others, but we can also be selfish, right? If we have freedom to make our own choices, that doesn't mean we always make the right choices. And so there's a lot of power that comes with freedom. And as I thought about this, I thought about when I was in school. Have you guys ever been in school and it's lunchtime and you see a kid and they don't have a lunch? And you have a lunch and other kids have lunches, you have? Okay, your friend, what did you do? You didn't know what to do? Right. And so Paul talks about a freedom we have. We have the freedom to make choices. And in those situations, it's not always easy to make the right choices. And he talks about that. I remember when I was a kid, and there was someone who didn't have lunch. And my mom packed my lunch, and it was my favorite stuff. It was Oreos. And I like peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, and so it was on my favorite bread. And so if I had like carrots and maybe, you know, some other stuff I didn't really like that much, it would have been easy for me to share. But I had all my favorite stuff. And so it was really hard for me to offer that other kid some of my food. But I felt kind of, in my heart, I felt like, what if I was that kid that didn't have the lunch, and everyone else had the lunch, and everyone else was eating? So these are the things that God and Paul are talking about that they want us to think about, right? And Jesus, when I went over there and I was talking, Jesus says, if you see anyone who's even thirsty and you have anything to drink, that we're supposed to offer them what we have. Because everything we have, whether it's our pretty dresses or our clothes or food or shelter, everything we have is a gift from God. And so we're supposed to share what we have. And I want to tell you guys what I did this weekend. I had a garage sale. Have you guys ever had a garage sale? Never? You're missing out. I'm inviting you to the next one. Garage sale. Do you guys like garage sales? Sometimes I like taking stuff that I know I'm not going to use anymore, and then you get money for it, right? So this was a really hard. I had freedom to make some choices this weekend. Not yet, but it was really hard. So I'm at this garage sale, right? And I had, who knows what a Wii is? The Wii gaming station. You guys do? Fun. What are some of your favorite games? Wii Racing, Wii Sports. Okay, I had a Wii. I had the Wii Fit, which I didn't use that often, where you step on it and you exercise. I had tons of games. I had the nunchucks, where you could fight. I had a microphone. You don't want to hear me sing, but I did. I had all this Wii stuff. And I wanted, it's worth a lot of money, right? And I wanted to at least get $140. So I saw a little girl come up, and she was so excited. She's like, Dad, look. And her dad was looking at everything, and he said, how much do you want? And I said, the lowest I'll go is $140. I really want, you know, it's worth a lot more. And I saw her face get so sad as her dad opened up his wallet, and he had $16. Right? That's a far way away from 140. And I saw her dad and me get really sad, right? Because he wanted her to be able to have this, but there was no way he could afford it. And so I had the freedom to make a choice right there. I could say, this is worth way more than $140, and too bad, too sad. I'm sorry. Or I had the choice to bring joy into this little girl's life by giving her this gaming system that I knew was really fun, right? And so I said, you can have it for $16. And she started jumping up and down, and she was so happy. And that is what Paul is talking about. That choices in life aren't always easy, right? And we can justify why we don't need to always do the thing that God wants us to do by giving so graciously and just giving to people freely. We can say, well, you know, it's worth a lot of money, right? Like, I can make excuses as to why not to do that, but God used me in that moment to give to this family. And so, as you guys go about your days, I want you to think about how God can use you. And there are a lot of things you guys could do that we can't do who are older. Like, I'm sure you guys are really good, number one, at gaming, right? At playing video games. Are you guys good at cell phones and iPads and stuff like that? iMovie, right? I'm sure your parents asked, how do I do this? Or why isn't this working? Yes. Okay, so you guys can help people when you see them in need. Sometimes if they're carrying a lot of bags, you guys can, who?
Help
them, yeah. Run up and grab and help them. Or when you see, I'm just letting you guys know this, if you don't, it's harder for older people to bend, including myself. So when you see us drop something, if you go and pick it up, that is like the, I know it seems silly, that's like a cup of water. That is like the biggest gift you could give us. When somebody already close to the ground grabs whatever I dropped and hands it to me, that is an amazing gift for me. So it's those types of things we can do. And so I got money from my garage sale, and I had freedom to do whatever I wanted with my money, and I decided to buy some cupcakes with my money. And I have the freedom to eat all these cupcakes if I want. Don't I? I mean, I bought these cupcakes with my hard-earned money. Do you guys think I should? What do you think God wants me to do?
Share.
Hold our money and hold things and not share them, but to give them. Because God will always, always, always provide for us.